and your date of birth, please?
1949.
It's the early hours of Thursday morning.
I think you were here the last time I was here.
I'm sure I was.
Yep, sorry.
And in Swindon Custody Suite, 67-year-old Richard Kidner has been arrested on suspicion of carrying out a sustained campaign of harassment.
He was warned on the 9th of January via email about his behaviour, and also again by me on the 12th of February. Despite this, he still continued with his pattern of behaviour, which has caused him upset and distress.
It's now down to local crime investigator Dave Miller to get to the bottom of what's been going on.
Just the two of us, is it?
It is, yeah. Okay, the reason you're here today is you were arrested at 5:28 this morning for harassing
a younger woman
who works at a stables.
Never heard of her.
Okay.
No, sorry. No, it's on. Yeah. Carry on.
Okay, this is a serious matter you're here for me.
I know it's a serious matter.
Okay.
I know it's serious. I wouldn't be here otherwise, would I?
Okay, so it's not a laughing matter, that's all.
No, I'm just a comment.
So you had an interest in one of the horses. What was the interest you had in the horse?
Oh, a syndicate, sharing a syndicate.
Syndicate. And was your interest in more than just the horse?
Well, eventually. I mean, she's a nice girl, you know what I mean.
At any point, has she asked you not to have contact with her?
Yeah.
Okay.
Numerous occasions.
On numerous occasions.
If you want the honest truth.
Do you understand if they say they don't want contact, you should cease that conduct?
Yeah, and I stayed away.
Well, she said you'd been turning up the yard unannounced and ringing me more than I was comfortable with. This was witnessed by grooms at the stables, who commented they thought it was strange and joked that he must have taken a liking to me.
Well, you're definitely right there.
We deal with sleazy blokes every day, unfortunately. Sex is a big drive in people, you know. It's one of our basic instincts, basic drives. That sometimes is going to get skewed in some people, and some people aren't going to know the boundaries.
Monday the 2nd of January, you turned up at the yard twice in one day. She said, I started feeling worried that his behaviour was becoming strange. On Friday the 6th of January, at approximately 2:30 in the morning, you turned up on her doorstep completely unwanted and uninvited. So did you turn up at 2:30 in the morning?
This is all out of proportion.
What did you or didn't you turn up?
Yes, I did.
So what was the reason for doing that?
To do nothing, just to see her, really. It was just an impulse.
So, okay, let's get down to brass tacks. Did you want to have sex with her then?
No. No, that's not what it's about.
If it's not sex, what's it about then?
I fancy a fence offer.
Okay, so it is sexual.
Well, no, it's not sexual. It's
you went because you fancy the pants off her. You see, you think
that sounds terrible.
People talk about people having multiple personalities. There were times in the interview where it was like talking to a 11-year-old child who's just starting to discover sex. So being quite excited and jokey about that. At other times, he appeared to be an adult who was fully aware of what he was doing and the impact that was having.
She said she sent a warning email regarding your behaviour, stating clearly what behaviour was appropriate as a member of the syndicate, and if you could not comply with this, it would be removed from the syndicate. Now, do you remember receiving that email?
I thought it was a come-on, actually.
You thought that was a come-on?
Yeah.
OK. I wouldn't see that as a come-on. And I don't think most people would.
It was all coming from inside Richard's head. If that's the way he approaches women in general, if he's trying to develop a relationship, and if he's getting no's from them, maybe he has to construct something that will encourage him to keep going. And it may be that he thought 97 no's will then lead to one yes.
3 o'clock in the morning, I had a bang on my front door, and when I looked out my bedroom window, it was Kidner, so I leant out the window and told him to go away.
She told me to fuck off.
Okay. At 8:30 in the morning, you were on the yard again. You were obviously angry and you were acting aggressively. She asked you not to get so close and tried to back away. You followed her and asked me what I was going to do now, as I was trapped and I couldn't get out. So did you do that?
I think I did, yeah. Yeah, I think I did.
And she managed to dodge out of the way and run
she
into the house.
She let me in there, that's the thing.
Where she rang the police. She said she asked her father to call you, and in her presence, She heard her father telling you in no uncertain terms to leave.
Fuck off, he said.
Okay.
So there you go.
We've got a moral duty to push it all the way. We've got to put pressure on them until there's a cognitive load, they call it. And all of a sudden they realise it's too much, and that happened a number of times with Richard, that there's, you know, yes, and he'd swear and explode, and yes, I know.
Okay, Richard, sorry to be personal, but do you have mental health issues?
No, I fucking don't! Do I seem as if I have mental health issues?
Well, what I'm having trouble to understand then is if somebody asks you not to contact them...
I haven't!
Richard, you have had contact, you've told me.
What do you mean by contact?
You're talking as if you don't understand. You've been imprisoned, I know, for harassing somebody else.
Yes, I know I was in bloody prison before! And I couldn't understand it then! What are they doing?
They're saying no, Richard, and you're ignoring them.
There's something called infatuation disorder, which may be what Richard's suffering from. If he is infatuated and he can't get that out of his head, he's going to keep going back, and that's not fair. That's not fair on the victim at all, and we've got to protect her. That's the first thing we've got to do. We've got to protect the victim. We've got to protect wider society.
What is going on here? What?
Well, what do you think's going on, Richard?
I don't know.
Well,
this is getting on my bloody wick. What is wrong with her?
So, Richard, you think this is getting on your wick. How do you think she feels?
She loves her.
See, that's the problem, isn't it?
Even though he's a reprehensible character, a small part of me would just want him to put my arm around Richard, because you think, what are you doing? You're in your late 60s. Is this your life? Come on, you've got to do something about this.
It's clear you don't understand when a woman says no to
well,
you.
I
obviously don't understand what that means.
How did I know what she meant, that I'm an unmarried man? How did I know what women want?
See, you're making a joke.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are, Richard.
Sake.
He's probably always going to have the same thoughts, desires, feelings, but whether he can control them, whether he can self-regulate is the matter. And maybe with some treatment, he can be given the tools to do that. If he can't, then he would just keep going into prison.
Richard Kidner, you are charged that between the 9th of January 2017 and the 28th of March 2017. Do you understand the charge?
I understand the charge, but I'm just saying it's absolutely ridiculous.
It sounds like a very old-fashioned, but an old-fashioned hospital for people with mental health issues might be the right sort of environment to try and get some treatment.
I'm just saying this is absolutely ridiculous that I got to stay here like
this.
Come
this way. Let's pop you back.
To try and at least prevent him from committing the same sort of offences, displaying that sort of behaviour.
It's a bit of a game for a minute.
Wake me up! Wake me up!
Wake me up!
Wake me up!
Wake me up!